My day begins at 8 in the morning. If you read through to the end, my day might seem a bit strange to you. The first thing I do is check all my social media. This takes about 5 to 10 minutes. It might be a bad habit, but it helps me wake up. After my morning routine, I do a 15-minute stretch. A significant part of my morning rituals is the morning pages, where I write down my thoughts and feelings for 15-20 minutes, usually related to the previous day. This helps me stay mindful, identify and address negative thoughts, and celebrate positive changes. I keep all my notes in Notion. I make breakfast, pour coffee, and start work exactly at 9 Ryu. First, I play some lo-fi music on Spotify. I always begin my day by analyzing what I did the previous day and planning for the current day. I'm a planner. I can work without a plan, but I know that with a plan, I make faster progress. Planning takes me 10-15 minutes. Then I check my emails and respond to them. Today, my work task is to perform data analysis. I will use a dataset extracted from PostgreSQL. Data analysis is similar to investigating a crime. During it, data analysts find patterns, identify anomalies, and test hypotheses using summary statistics and visualization. I use Visual Studio Code and Python, particularly Pandas and NumPy libraries, for data manipulation and visualization. By the way, I've been using the Pomodoro technique for over a year now. I work for 25 minutes, or 30 minutes, and then take a 5-minute break. After 4 Pomodoros, I take a longer break of 15-20 minutes. The Pomodoro technique helps me work more efficiently. I import data, and one of the analysis steps is data cleansing. I identify and fix any issues if possible. Now it's time for lunch. Lunch typically lasts 30-60 minutes. If I don't have any personal tasks, I use this time to work and finish early. But I make sure to rest for at least 30 minutes, or my productivity decreases significantly. After lunch, I have a call with the product manager to discuss current and upcoming tasks. I don't like using the camera during these calls because it's hard to concentrate on the conversation. As an excuse, I can refer to a Harvard Business Review study that found that keeping the camera on during meetings leads to fatigue. I'll leave a link to the study in the description. One of my supervisors almost forced us to turn on the camera. If we didn't, he asked us to leave the meeting. Next, I dive into data analysis, asking and answering questions sequentially using statistics and data visualization, recording my findings in a document. This is an important part of my work. It's crucial to dedicate at least 1 hour a day to professional development. Progressive companies encourage their employees to develop and allocate an hour for it during working hours. But not all companies understand this. I use books, educational platforms, and articles. At 6 Yao, my work is done. I can attend to personal matters. Usually around 6 in the evening, I spend 30-40 minutes working out in the gym to recharge. Then it's time for dinner. Sometimes I feel like all we do is eat and generate trash. In the evening, I work on my own projects. Right now, I'm writing a post for my Telegram channel. I have many ideas for posts, and every day I come up with several new ones. I don't even know when I'll publish them. Frankly, I'm hesitant to publish some topics because I don't know how the audience will react. By the way, I'll leave a link to my Telegram channel in the description. Afterward, I start working on my application. It's one of my personal projects. I also have about half an hour to practice English. Today, I'm reviewing grammar. At 11 hours, it's personal downtime. During this time, I don't work on anything. I go to bed at 12 tiru. So friends, if my day seems too busy to you, believe me, I sometimes feel unwell during the filming. But I really make the most of my weekdays. As for the weekends, I take it easy. I follow the concept of small steps in different directions daily. Since there are many directions, I constantly switch between them, which is a form of relaxation in itself. Of course, if I concentrated on just one task all day, I'd go crazy. It's hard for me. The Pomodoro technique also helps me. As I mentioned earlier, by alternating work and breaks,